Corey Crawford. Boy, Nielsen did everything he wanted to do, just not able to elevate it.
Saves the captain, as usual, first up for Quenneville. Saves right in. 1-0 Chicago.
Real simple, good speed, head up all the way. Right on the ice under the right pad. Big goal by Taves.
One of the Islander youngsters, Nino Niederreiter, next up for them. Niederreiter sticking it beautifully. Able to score. Crawford able to keep the right pad out.
A lot of stick handles. Probably about four too many for my liking, but Crawford denies.
Next up is Marion Hossa. He can win it for the Hawks. Hossa shot it high.
Well, maybe Big Hoss might go to the same spot path that Jonathan Taves went to. And a good stop there by the Chicago kid, Al Montoya.
Yeah, good save. I thought he had missed an up, but Montoya got a piece. Here's Molson now. Needing to score for the Islanders. Molson in. Goalpost. A little help from the iron for Corey Crawford. And he backs out the Blackhawks to their 15th victory of the season. Some anxiety in the United States tonight. The Hawks and their fans can celebrate their 8th home ice win. They're 8-2-2 here in this rink. Our Lexus player of the game is that man, Jonathan Taves, who came up with a huge play in a tie game late in the second period.
Yeah, shorthanded, lifts up the stick up. Milan Urcina after Seabrook and Keith get this puck in the middle of the ice. Huge goal. And the captain has been doing it all, Pat, over the course of the last 5 weeks.
So a chance to celebrate for the Hawks tonight. And let's enjoy the three-star selection.
The game from the Blackhawks, number 10, Patrick Sharp. The number 2-star of the game from New York, number 26, Matt Molson. And the number 1-star of the game from the Blackhawks, number 19, Jonathan Taves. Please turn your attention to the Blackhawks bench, where Sarah Kustok is with tonight's number 1-star of the game, Jonathan Taves.
Battle, certainly plenty of challenging stretches during this game you guys were able to overcome. Coming on the heels of a loss like Tuesday night, how do you characterize a win like tonight?
Well, I think we're happier with the way we used the crowd and the way we played for our fans the other night. We were a little disappointed ourselves the way we came out coming off that road trip. But most of all, we're glad to be back here in Chicago. We got a lot of home games coming up, so got to keep winning, getting points, doesn't matter how. So we made a few mistakes there in the third, but we'll learn from it and we'll be all right.
In a grueling and critical win like tonight goes to a shootout, take us through your thought process when you're stepping out there and you're taking it.
Well, you want to win. So, I mean, you kind of go into the shootout with an idea of what you're going to do in your head. But, there's no horse around. You want to score. You want to find a way, especially when Crow makes 3 big saves like he did. So it's fun to win that way, especially in front of our own fans. It was a great night.
Also, an important go-ahead goal in that second period, shorthanded. You now have 8 points in the last 4 games. How are you feeling out there on the ice and just your comfort level of where your game is at?
I feel good. I mean, I think a lot of us feel like we just can go out there and play, and things are starting to come together. We're staying patient with the power play and other things like that, and just got to keep working, and the goals and that sort of thing will come. And same thing with the win. So, like I said, to get on the score sheet and find a way to help us win tonight, it's good for everybody.
All right, congrats, Johnny. Thanks so much.
Thanks, guys.
So some happy news from West Madison Street tonight. Stay with us. More to come on the Jose Cuervo post-game show coming up with Chris Bowden and Steve Conrad. Now for Dave Ross, Dave Turner, and Mike Leary, and Freddie Olcha. Matt Foley, hoping you enjoyed the broadcast. We know you enjoyed the outcome. The Hawks 5, the Islanders 4 in a shootout. Comcast Sportsnet is part of the NBC Sports Group.
Hi, everyone. Gail.